Hey guys, welcome to another episode in the deep playthrough of GT7. I am not having the best day. It's quite frustrating. The previous Sardinia circuit experience in a diesel Le Mans car, it was super frustrating. And these Tokyo Expressway tests are also quite annoying because you only have to graze the wall and you're out of it. And it is not only one circuit experience, but there are six track layouts, so it really is a huge circuit experience. And I do like it. I mean, more content is better than less content, but yeah, I'm just not having the best time currently, so already apologies up front if I start ranting. Here we go. Final section, straight, and then left-hander, and then a long right-hander. Oh, fuck, here we go. Immediately here, the frustration rises. You hardly have any visual cues where to brake. Everything looks similar, it is just all so absolutely fucked up. It's not fun at all. And if you make one mistake, you can... You can start over because there are such long straights behind one of the corners that each little mistake really has like... carry your mistake all the way through the long straights afterwards. Pressing the wrong button. I'm doing it myself. So it happens so often. It's so annoying. So annoying. Everything is just so incredibly annoying in this game. I mean, I still love it, but the game itself, but it also, it's just like Dark Souls. I really like the game, but it also has so much frustrating items in it. And I will only get more frustrated. So maybe I should just drop it for today because it's not good for anybody. There should be a modicum of fun playing again. Thank you. Tokyo circuit experience, there are six of these. Track variations with all their own sectors and full lap attack. So the amount of frustration will continue for quite a while. Now, I really don't. But I really don't, from these sector tests, I don't remember all these braking points and stuff. Everything looks similar over here. Totally screwed it up. Here, would have carried so much more speed from there.
Thank you.
is they're too similar.
Best records. 2.5 seconds.
time. He's my best friend. Basically, get through there pretty much is sixth only. Understeer this car. Alright, this is a car I will never ever drive in the game again. Fuck this car. Fuck this car. Understeer, it's so annoying. I'm really putting I'm really putting a lot of steering inputs and nothing is happening. This car can only go for straight ahead. I don't even know how long the episode has been running. I think I'm already way over the 25 minute mark. So, guys, again, sorry for my ranting. It is, or maybe not. I think I just forgot to set the timer. That's it. All right, let's do 10 more minutes. I wanted to say I will continue in the next one, and the good thing of the continuing in the next one is that I can disregard all my failed attempts, so you will immediately see the successful attempt in the start of the next episode. But I'm just going to continue. I think I may have, I'm still below the 25 minute marker. I have no idea, to be honest. I don't think it's even that hard. Learning is pure frustration. Because you really want to be on the edge. But being close on the edge means easy to go over it. And you don't have any runoff here. If you screw up, you start over. If you even look at the wall wrongly, that's enough to game on for you. Right, but this one, fuck me, I do need to break a little bit now. I think I can gain some time there in that one. There. fucking decisive. Either you commit to a point or a cross. Guys, I will continue in the... God damn it, I can hardly think anymore the amount of frustration. I will continue in the next episode, and then at the start of the next one, immediately the successful attempt, if that will happen ever, will be visible, because I will discard all the failed attempts in between, which probably will at least be another 20. God damn it, what an annoying test. And then to think that there are 5 more of these Tokyo Expressway variants, which are probably all just as annoying. So it is what it is. I do want to gold them all, so I will just persevere. But god fucking damn, how annoying is this? And also in the cars, this car drives like a total brick. It's just totally understeery. It's not fun. All these modern cars there, none of them are fun in my view. If you really want to have fun, go to the 90s, go to the maybe early 2000s, go to the 80s, go to the 70s, go to the 60s. All this modern crap can really, for my part, it can all be cancelled, all modern motor racing. It's all just retarded. But anyway, sorry, and then again, I'm going on a rant. We'll be continuing the game, and in the next episode, successful attempt of this circuit experience, the first out of, I think, six. Let's check it out. Six in Tokyo. Man, I am fucking frustrated. Crazy. It may even be seven, I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have central clockwise, east clockwise, south clockwise, central, counter. We also do everything counterclockwise. That's why there are so many. And again, in the same car. Oh my fucking hell. So you do three variants in three cars, but you do them in two directions. All right, it is what it is. We'll continue in the next one, guys. At least, god damn it, now it disappears. I wanted to say at least the tune was, the background tune in the menu was cool. It was Will Smith, Summertime, but then a very relaxed version of it. Anyways, I will stop babbling about. We'll end the episode here, continue in the next one. Guys, I hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you there. For the meantime, don't forget, always do keep on gaming. Later.